Welcome to week five of the Joe Reich Show. Wingate on the road for the first time in South Atlantic Conference play, going to Jefferson City, Tennessee to play Carson-Newman, a place where Wingate had not won in their football history until Saturday. Wingate came home with a 38-35 overtime win. A lot of records being broken, so to say. Carson-Newman had a 15-game winning streak against Wingate. Coach Reich had never beaten Carson-Newman.
Right.
Finally get over that hump. You know, sometimes we say, well, Carson-Newman's at the very end of the season. There's a ton on the line. Not as much as past years,
right,
but just a great win for your team to finally get over that hump and kind of ride the momentum into the rest of the year.
Sure. And, you know, even if you take away the fact that it was Carson-Newman and it was such a big game, we hadn't beaten him in a long time. I think just our position in the league, you know, being 0-1 in the league and then going to Carson-Newman, I mean, it was a must-win game for us. It was a game we had to win, and you know, our guys played that way. Our guys played with a sense of urgency, played with a lot of passion, and came out and got the W after getting behind early. And you know, we need to get out of that habit of trying to come back and win games. So we just need to start a little stronger next time.
You know, we talked about it. You know, after the game, we lose to Catawba, and then say, well, Wingate will just go up and beat Carson-Newman for the first time in 15 years, you know, since they just lost to Catawba. But, you know, if you reverse it, you beat Catawba at home, you lose to Carson-Newman, a tough place to play.
Right.
And either way you look at it, at the end of the day, you had to get out of there 1-1,
yes,
and in some way you did. I mean, did you talk about saying, you know, we put ourselves in a hole now, even though we want to beat Carson-Newman just because we never have, this
right,
all of a sudden is a must-win.
Yeah, you know, we didn't. It was more about, hey, we have to play well. We have to come out with the victory. It was less about, hey, this is Carson-Newman. Maybe that's the key. We really, you know, I think everybody knew, hey, you know, we're 1-21 against Carson-Newman lifetime right now. So, you know, going into that game. So I think the thought was, but it wasn't really on that. The thought was, hey, we need this game. We just lost to Catawba. We need to come back. We need to get on the board. We need to come out of the first two games 1-1, whichever way that was. And if, you know, if the Catawba win if the Catawba loss for us was propelled us to this win, then so be it. You know, there are a lot of different reasons, a lot of different wherefores and all that stuff. But I think the guys just focused in and came away with a win. So it's definitely something I'm happy with our performance.
Well, we'll check out that start. It was another rough start for this Wingate football team in the first quarter. You know, as Coach Reich said, have struggled, trailed just about every game this year. Carson-Newman, their first drive, Coach, we talked about it, limit the big plays. Took them 10 plays to get on their first touchdown. So here's the second down run. But, again, soak up some clock and make them beat you down the field.
Yeah, and that was the thought going in. And, again, I think that's the key. Again, when you play a team like Carson-Newman, you have to eliminate the huge, huge plays. I mean, that was the touchdown there was a little too big for us to begin with. But, you know, make them earn it. Make them go the field.
So they score in 5 minutes. You get the ball the first possession. And a couple incomplete passes and a run. Not the start you probably wanted, obviously.
No, definitely not. You know, particularly for our receivers, which we feel is the strength of our team. We felt like just, you know, to come out and to, you know, to not get a great start for us as a receiving core was definitely disappointing. But, you know, you need to keep coming back.
Here's the second drive. You force a punt, get the ball back. And to Delrick's credit, he's fighting for a couple extra yards, but he does have the ball stripped out.
He does. You know, I think he was down here, but, you know, that's the way that, you know, you got to play what you see. You know, when we slowed it down and we thought his knee was down. But, again, you still got to hold on to it. I mean, it's not, you know, again, one thing about Delrick is he's always going to fight for the extra yard. He's a great run after the catch guy. He's been so vital to our whole offense this year, and that's, you know, unfortunately that was not one of his best plays.
So this is their third drive, up 7-0. You've got a three and out, a fumble. They're inside the 25-yard line, and as good as they are in this opportunity, they punch it in here, a touchdown, and just like that, Coach, you're down 14-0. And I really thought this was, hey, if you're going to win this game, you got to score here. And an absolutely great drive for your team here to get back into the game and score your first touchdown.
And, you know, again, we just came out. We kind of woke up, started executing the things that we do, just go back and do the fundamental things and run our offense the way we need to run it. And when we do that, we're pretty good when we just execute our own offense and just the simple fundamentals. And
here's Nelson the second time for 9 yards. Coach, he had a couple games where, you know, got met in the backfield 4 or 5 yards. He had a lot of yards for loss for him. None on Saturday against Carson-Newman. So a big deal for your team. Again, the drive continues here, and Clyburn gets hammered on that far side. So a fat pass interference, and you'll get a sack here to drop you back. And that'll switch fields, go back to second quarter. So the second quarter starts, you're faced with a second down and 15. After a Nelson Woods run, here's the touchdown play.
A great little route by Delrick here, good finish. That's a route we'd worked hard on all week, and fortunately we were able to execute it well. And I'll tell you, the one thing that stands out to me here is Carson Grant playing, you know, starting out for left starting for us at left tackle. His first career start for Brock Mueller really came up big for us the whole day.
We talked about cutting out the big plays. Here's really the only one they got that day, but talk about it, that option. They were so successful getting way outside, and you know, that's what Carson-Newman is known for, a quick strike.
That's exactly right, and I think this kind of, again, I thought Coach James did a great job here in preparing our defense all week, and you know, we went in with a certain game plan. We took them out of one type of option. They went to the lead option a little bit more. And had some success here, and we eventually came back at halftime and made a couple adjustments. Bobby did a great job at halftime. Made a couple adjustments and be able to kind of shut them down there with some of that stuff.
So down 21-7, right back to that 14-point deficit. And Coach Nelson didn't come into this season with many catches in a career, but he's really getting involved out in the flat there, and then he comes right back with a nice 13-yard run.
You know, I think we're starting to figure, hey, that guy's pretty good when he has the ball in his hands. Let's get it to him. He's definitely a weapon when he's got the football.
Yeah, credit to offensive line. Nelson had some huge holes at times. You know, when he had a run over 4 or 5 yards, it was usually 9 or 14 or 15. Here's another nice play right over the middle. That slant just was perfect all day.
Yeah, Cody throws this ball real well. He throws this route real well. And again, I would say that's a strength of Chris Bowden as well, the receiver there. That's something he does extremely well. So, again, just executing the fundamentals, executing our offense.
Two plays later, Woods for 5 yards. We'll watch this one more time, and then we see Ellington again, 16 yards. And again, he doesn't have any easy catches. He's always taking a huge lick, got up here a little bit slow. But we've seen that play 100 times this year.
Absolutely. He does this really well. He attacks the Mike linebacker, gets up over the top, and he's been taking a beating a little bit here. He got up a little slow, and I'll give him credit, though. Boy, he's a tough cookie. Keeps coming back and getting it done.
So Carson Newman gets the ball back. Lead down to 7. Here's a 3rd-and-7 play, a rare pass for them. Tyrone turns around, but just came up short again, 59-yard pass play. So they get down in your territory. But here's good job. This is not a replay. 1st down, no gain. Quickly watch. 2nd down. And again, nowhere to go.
Yep.
And then we see the touchdown run here. So, I mean, it's just tough to defend.
Yeah, it is. You know, you shut them down, you shut them down, you shut them down, then they pop something here. That's what their offense is based on. And again, we went into it saying, look, no big plays. We gave up a couple, but you know, again, I think when you're playing a team like that, they're going to get one of those every now and then. So, definitely at halftime, it's interesting because at halftime, even though we're down a couple scores, I think we all felt good at halftime. I think we felt like, okay, if we can make some adjustments, we felt like we could move the ball on them. We felt like we could score points on them. It had a good feel in the locker room. Sometimes you go in the locker room at halftime and it just doesn't feel right. I walked in there, I could sense our team's confidence that, hey, you know, we can play with these guys. Not only can we play with them, we feel like we're better than them. We just need to correct a few mistakes, make a couple adjustments on defense, and we can win this game. You could just feel it at halftime.
It seems like in the past, a lot of times there'd be a Carson-Newman game where they'd get a couple quick scores and you just go a quick 3 and out. Or
right.
4 or 5 plays. It didn't seem like that was there. You know, they scored that last touchdown we just saw with 9 minutes left. But your team put together a pretty good drive, about 8 or 9
right.
plays. It wasn't like you just gave the ball right back. You know, kept the defense off the field. Plenty of time to have Coach James come down and say, let's fix this. Let's talk about this. Do this. As opposed to them get to sit down for 5 minutes, have to run back out there.
Right, yeah. Or get the punt team back out there, right. Which is a bunch of defensive guys too. So, yeah, the offense, even we talk about that in terms of it's not just whether you score or not. It's field position, it's series. We compare series. All right, they ran 6 plays for this many yards. We need to run 7 plays for even more yards. It's a back and forth field position, play the percentages kind of thing. And we certainly needed to come back with some drives, come back and get some big scores. You mentioned that, you know, we're down 14-0 to come back with a score there. You might may have been the key to the game right there. So it really makes it, it's not just one play here or there. It's not just scoring sometimes. It's how the drives compare to one another, for sure.
Well, 2 years ago, Wingate trailed, or led by 13 at a half. Carson-Newman put up 21 in the third quarter. This
right.
year, you trail by 14 at the half, and Carson-Newman doesn't put up any points in the third quarter. Big difference there as we'll check out the second half highlights.